So guys, do you know that I love indie perfumery? Well, I also love to discover new indie houses and then highlight them for you. And that is exactly what we'll do in this video, because today the spotlight is on the Canadian indie house called Malik Perfumes. And not only I will tell you everything about it in this video, but also review for you my top 5 favorite Malik perfumes. So if you want to learn more about it, well, then just keep on watching. Thank you so much for tuning into this video, in which I'm indeed very, very excited to highlight for you an indie perfume house based in Vancouver, Canada, called Malik Perfumes, and it was founded by Matthew Malik, who actually discovered me first, because I never heard of this indie house, and then Matthew reached out to me via email and we started chatting, and I got curious in his work. So he sent me one fragrance of him that not only impressed me, I was intrigued and wanted to try more. So finally, I collected all of my top 5 favorites that I will review for you today. But before we get started, I wanted to let you know that Matthew is a self-taught perfumer and he studies vintage perfumery. He's also very open about perfume making on his Instagram account that I highly recommend you to follow him on, because you can learn a lot about perfumery and also updates about Malik perfumes, and he's super knowledgeable. So if you have an Instagram profile, check out the description box where you'll find more helpful links. And without further ado, let me tell you about my top 5 favorites from Malik perfumes that I highly recommend to get at least samples of on his Etsy webshop. So it all started with this perfume called Civet Cat Chypre number 50 that he sent me, and you might remember my review on it that I called aphrodisiac in a bottle, and I still stand by that, because this is a very sexy fragrance that is created in the Chypre style, and it is not just a simple Chypre, it's an animalic Chypre. And you might remember that I love animalistic perfumes, and Chypre is one of my most favorite perfume genres. So, Civet Cat Chypre sounded just like me, and when I first tried it, I was basically very much impressed, wowed, and that perfume showed me that Matthew's super talented, because to make a super realistic animalic perfume not skanky requires talent. And I mean, like, it's realistic. Civet in there, which is one of the dirtiest animalic notes, plays an important role, probably the main role, but it's not skanky. So what does that mean? Well, it doesn't smell like poo. It smells elegantly vintage and fresh, because when you spray it on, it opens with a very citrusy and juicy scent. There are also some very high quality flowers, absolutes, attars, but they are rather on the background, so they don't disturb that beautiful, juicy, animalic vibe that this fragrance creates. And to me, it smells a little bit like animals having sex somewhere on the nature, and it's very wearable in the warmer weather just because it's so uplifting, you know. So it's juicy, it's fun, you know, it's very animalic. And if you are scared of animalic perfumes but you want something animalic, you know, you want to go into that skankiness that you wouldn't be like, oh my god, that smells like poo. Yeah, it's vintage, it's elegant, it's for men and women with great performance, because it projects quite well. And I think if you are very much familiar with animalic perfumes, yes, this is gonna be like the star in your collection. So, you know, it all started with Civet Cat Chypre, but then I wanted more, and I got more. So we are moving on to the next perfume that is called Vienna 1900, and this is chocolate patchouli. By the way, as you can notice, the design of the bottle is different now, and I prefer the current style. And this is a chocolatey patchouli. But if you expect some chocolate sweets, then you won't get it in here, because it's rather about the chocolatey side of patchouli than the chocolate itself. And I like that, so it's not a true gourmand. It smells like one of the most expensive, high quality perfume materials, patchouli, to me personally, that also adds that truly niche feeling to the fragrance. And another thing that I really like about it, it's texture. So when you spray it on, it's kind of fresh in the opening with almost like a berry twist, but then that cacao absolute, orris butter and milk accord make it very creamy, milky. Sandalwood in there creates a very round effect, and patchouli provides depth but with gorgeous sweetness. And so to me, it smells like wealthy life, and sometimes it reminds me of my hairdresser. And every time I'm at her salon, I tell her that I wanna visit her every day, because in my opinion, only wealthy, rich people can allow themselves to go to the hairdresser every single day. And I get like a whiff of hairspray in there too. So it's, you know, you're dressed up, you're going out, and you just have high goals and you want to achieve something in your life. Well, with that, this chocolate patchouli can help you. And by the way, I also want to tell you that when my mom smelled like so many perfumes from my collection, she was impressed by this one, and she even wanted to apply some on herself. So if you love patchouli, and if you love that Coromandel from Chanel's exclusive French, they have something in common, although this one is a bit more interesting and with a vintage but not old-fashioned touch. So although I really love those two, those are not my number ones. This next one is my number one, and I did not expect Mushin Kyoto Incense to be love at first sniff, but it turned out to be exactly that. So the thing that I was worried about is actually incense. That's what this fragrance is about. But this is probably the finest, noblest incense fragrance I've ever smelled. And you know, it is inspired by the Japanese city Kyoto, the city of thousand temples, where monks burn incense as part of their ceremony. And this particular one is inspired by the scent of a rare specific incense called Kiara, if I'm not wrong. And Matthew actually studied and worked in Japan for many, many years. Even his wife is Japanese, if I'm not wrong. And just the fact that they live in a small apartment where he creates handmade perfumes, so creative and truly high quality smelling. I mean, like, he can compete, if not beat, so many other very well-known niche companies with his talent and inspiration. But anyway, coming back to Mushin, right? It is inspired by this gorgeous incense, and it is uplifting, although in the opening it was rather boozy to me. So I asked, why so, Matthew? And he told me probably because of osmanthus. And I need to agree with him, because it has leathery but also apricot part, which can act boozy sometimes. So it's very fresh, it's peaceful, it is woody but very light and also powdery. And you know, I love powder, but this is powder unlike anything else, with orris butter, with violets and with real oud. It is close to the perfection that no one can get to, but Matthew came pretty close with Mushin. That stays linear, but it doesn't need any change, you know, and its yash is phenomenal. You might even remember that I mentioned Mushin in one of my latest top lists, in the one with perfumes from my collection with the best yash, and in the video with top favorite perfumes from my collection. And it's not only one of my favorite perfumes, it's probably my number one fragrance discovery of 2020, which is crazy to say that, but you know what? This to me is love at first sniff, oh, that I'm still in love with. Alright, so we are coming to the very fun fragrance now, and it is called Golden Guy Japanese Tobacco, and you're not allowed to wear it on your skin. Why? Well, I'll tell you in a second, but first of all, Golden Guy is a tribute to the area of Tokyo where is this Golden Guy Bar District. And so it is inspired by the most creative artistic place in Tokyo, Golden Guy. And there you can find so many different tiny bars where creative people gather together.
And anyways, I wanted to capture some of the eccentricities, the stylization, the smoke, the liqueur, and the nightlife as expressed in the Golden Guy.
And it sounds so much fun, and I want to go there with Matthew as my guide.
And I'm going to start with this liqueur here, into which I will tincture some beautiful pipe tobacco that I picked up today. So we're going to take this tobacco, put it in this liqueur, tincture it. I'm going to heat it up and put it on my magnetic stir so it'll tincture a little bit faster. Maybe it'll be done in about a month. I think it will capture the essence of it. And upon this, I'm going to build a gin accord and also a green absinthe accord, right?
And so probably now you understand why you're not allowed to wear it on your skin, because it contains real nicotine. But you know what? If you're a smoker and you want some extra nicotine power, don't smoke, just wear Golden Guy. Particularly if you love sweet liquor-like scents, oh my god, it is powerful. It is very teasing, it is heady and a little bit cloying, as if you drank too much and now you're in this sweet drunk paradise. So you get all of the fruity liquor feeling and tobacco that is not too masculine, you know, it smells just like very relaxing. And there is rose absolu, there is high quality vanilla in there, and overall I can tell you it's fun, it's creative, and there are multiple different absinthe, Canadian club whiskey, and even gin accords. So yeah, don't drink, don't smoke, just wear this perfume and you'll get the teasing boost with it. You'll stay healthy and smell very, very sexy. And the final fragrance that was my latest discovery is Madeleine Peach number 7. And this one celebrates Shipra in the face of one of the finest ones from Guerlain that is called Mitsoko. And you know, it is a very well-known perfume and I personally like it a lot. You know, it's one of my most favorite houses. Matthew is very comfortable with Shipra genre, and this is his favorite perfume that he called after his mom. And so I like the opening because it is very vintage. It smells like aldehydic peaches, very, very fresh. But then they really go into the apricot and floral direction, and only in the dry down you get that lipsticky, powdery, less mossy than Mitsoko scent.
In this perfume, I've merged the peachy, fruity top notes with gardenia and jasmine and ylang ylang, so nice, fruity, soft, white materials. And then the dry down is going to be kind of this classic 1920s, 1930s deer musk, mosquito, fluffy, nice dry down.
That to me personally smells like the night out of your life. And if you love truly sultry and truly vintagey, almost old-fashioned like scents, and if you miss original Mitsoko, check this one out. You might be pleasantly surprised.
Yeah, so I just love the imagery of, you know, rotting peach, and if you cut a peach in half, you know, kind of looks like a woman's thing, and then so kind of like there's like death and birth, and then you've got the story of the love story and the Japanese connection and all these things. So it's quite an interesting perfume. You'll find this is not like a modern fruity light bubblegum teenager perfume. It's quite dark. It's got quite a bit of musk, and then also the spicy cinnamon gives lift to it, because the idea of this perfume is a spicy peach perfume.
And if you're going out all dressed up, you know this is a special occasion. This is the special scent for it. And that, my dear friends, completed this video, which I sincerely hope you enjoyed watching. And if you learned something new, please let me know your feedback in the comments. Also, which of these five favorites of mine interested you the most? I highly recommend you to first of all check out his website. Link is below. You can learn about other fragrances that he offers. Some are inspired by Canada, where he is based, and there are some truly classy masculine offerings. But I'm personally interested in his real oud fragrance, so I would highly recommend you just to order samples and be truly wowed and impressed by how high quality they smell and easily can beat some niche, very well-known fragrances. Matthew is talented. I wish him, you know, success and big achievements. And I would like to know, what do you think about this video? What do you think about this brand? The last thing I want to add, that the performance of these perfumes is amazing. So you'll pay for high quality. A little bit goes a long way, particularly if you are a fan of vintage perfumes or vintage inspired fragrances. This is the best house I can recommend you to smell. And some of his perfumes last on the clothes for many days, like Mushin, like Civet Cat Chypre, and like Golden Guy. If you have any questions left, go ahead, let's chat in the comments. And if you don't mind, please give me thumbs up for inspiring you to discover a new indie houses. Let's support those smaller brands that need us. And please subscribe to my channel if you're new here. And on that note, stay tuned, smell good. We'll see each other next one really soon. Bye, guys.